self-shifting, one of her powers, there's involuntary, voluntary, partial control, and then passive static control. Now, I'll use the word static and dynamic confusingly, but it'll make sense once I mention them. Involuntary, Jenny is at the whim of fate or some other force or factor of when and where she shifts to. Again, from the crossing over worlds, I chose to have her. She's called to shift. I couldn't find a really good example in the other ones, though. There have been like other things where she's yes. It's time to go.
Yeah.
But later on in the comic, she does be able to do it voluntarily, mm-hmm. which is where she can control where and when she shifts. Now, the late shift is a good example of several things.
Yes, very much.
It is like the original introductory comic. I made my own introductory comic for the Shifter Archive, mm-hmm. just so I don't have to worry about copyright, though. I'm pretty sure Nelson would be fine with
it. Oh, yeah, yeah.
I haven't been able to get a hold of Rob, so...
Ah, well.
And this is, I'll bring it up later, partial control. Jenny has partial or limited control of how, where, when she shifts to and from the scandal sheet, which is a great story arc, actually. I think it was like maybe the first story arc.
Yeah, I would say so.
Really early.
Yeah, because it ran, what is it, like 20-some, 30-some strips or something? It ran for a while in that comic, where she just sort of appears. And if I remember correctly, she's met all the characters in the future, mm-hmm. and now she has inadvertently shifted to the past where nobody knows who she is. Mm-hmm. And it really had great fun just kind of messing with people and interacting with them. But I enjoyed that one a lot.
She says, actually, in the comic, she says that she's never been able to shift back to a place she's been before. But she kept trying, and, this is what happened.
Yep.
We'll talk about something a little bit later, which will come into nature. Which could be an alternate version of this reality in the past, but otherwise there's the passive or static, as in Jenny's mind shifts between her other realities, but her body remains. Again, Black Bloody Valentine as an example of this. It's almost the only example of this.
Yes,
so it's like passive, it was static because she's kind of staying there. I don't know. I'm trying to come up with labels for these things.
Yeah, it's tough just because of the infinite nature of the character and stuff to generalize into specific categories each thing.
Next is cognizance, her power. And let's see. It's what cognizance is. If I spelled it correctly, Zents with a Z, I don't know. There's no cognizance, omnipotence, collective, aggregate, and limited. None. Jenny cannot access knowledge and thoughts of other Jennies. Hard to find an example of, so I'm not trying. Omnipotence. The extent to Jenny's knowledge is infinite or indefinite due to her infinite selves. A good example is from the crossover thingy, which she basically says that. she's seen it all, so she kind of knows everything.
Yep.
Collective. Jenny can passively access and share in the collective minds of her other selves. This is kind of a hard example to find because it's kind of, a lot of the examples are gonna be the next slide, but this is from Autumn Lake, in which Jenny is pulled in by one of the characters' machines and sucks her out of her normal loop and says, this guy makes me want to hurl him. All my other selves think he's really ugly too.
I've used the concept once, though I never actually outright said that this is what it was. There's a page in the Chronicles where she closes her eyes, she focuses. The monster that she's fighting at the time is basically jumping at her. She opens her eyes, I do kind of a little energy effect with it, and she's basically harnessed that energy, or harnessed that knowledge of exactly how to move, when to move, to make the sword that she's carrying fly in the air, hit all of the limbs, and come back to her. And it was just one page that I used. It's, again, an idea I've wanted to use, and this was the only page I've ever used it on, but it's... Again, it's as I see it, it's kind of an aspect of the character, the grandeur-ness, which I know we'll get to in a bit, but...
Well, the next one is the aggregate. Jenny is actively accessing, must actively access and share in the collective minds with her other selves, like a computer search. In the scanless sheet, she actually does do that, and I think I think a lot of times when people use Jenny contacting your other selves, it's usually like, I'm doing it now.
Yeah, yeah.
Which I think with the example you got was more like, I'm doing it now, versus yeah. It was just kind of there.
Yes, I would, yes, I agree with that.
Restricted or limited access to certain knowledge, aspects, and or thoughts, and of and or about other Jennies. Jenny Everywhere's Infinite Quark Time is a good example of this, kind of stemming from a couple of inspirations, including the death of Jenny Everywhere. Here's a scene where other Jennies come to this funeral, and they say, it was like, wouldn't we be going to these all the time? Because they're kind of drawn there, but they don't remember it ever happening before. So it's kind of limited. There's a mystery to this, except one character kind of remembers some of it. So it's like, that's kind of the going for this whole comic. And it's really cool. It's a comic done in Second Life.
Yeah, yeah. Gwen Patton.
Yep.
And it's currently still running. One of the two or three, I think, that are currently still.
This is the other one that's available to buy.
Yes, which I've also picked up a copy of that. It's a very good read and very well done considering, you know, the Second Life. Like, I don't know how to use the technology on that.
I couldn't figure out how to get out of the freaking door. It's like, these controls are just cumbersome.
But yeah, to do an entire comic is quite astounding for me.
There are other shifting powers. None, exchange, transport, or transform. This means shifting things other than herself. There's none where Jenny...
She just does what she does.
Yeah, she can only shift herself.
Yes.
And assume that she can take clothes and personal items too, otherwise this would be a very different type of comic.
So in essence, a sort of self-teleportation sort.
Yeah. And I just really love this one-off strip where she's just like so pissed off about this stupid adventure. It's like, it's over with, I'm out of here. I think she's supposed to be shifting at the end with like a tunnel. There's like different ways that she can shift.
Yeah, sometimes it's just she's there, sometimes there's a portal or a tunnel,
or
sometimes
she's like
a gateway.
She phases in or something like that. So there's different ways to do that too. Exchange. Jenny can exchange one object for another from a different reality via shifting it.
My favorite, I would say, obviously.
Yep. From the Jenny Everett Chronicles.
Yeah.
Kind of a at chance here, or just trying a little bit harder, versus some may have a little bit more control over that.
Yep, a little variety, but...
But then there's transport, where she can transport others as well as herself during the shift. Here, this is from a storyline within a pessimistic sense of inadequacy, which Jenny pops in to pick up a couple of the two other characters here that accidentally landed in another universe. And so they called her up and was like, Jenny, can you come get us? And then there's transforming. Now, here there's one page in your comic I didn't understand if... where she takes a piece of wood and turns it into glue. I don't know if she was exchanging it or if she
was
transforming
it. That was an exchange. The transform that I would use is the beginning of the Chronicles, in which she anchors herself to a universe by touching a person from that universe, and her clothes change during that as well. And then she gains the knowledge that he had of that reality. Was one page that I did in the...
Well, that's a power I didn't have on here, but we got another one here. This one is from Legend of Jenny Everywhere, where she's basically kind of transforming herself. It's the only example I could really find that is definite transformation.
Yep.
We're kind of getting up on time here.
Yep.
Space-time shifting. They're non-dynamic spatial, static spatial, static temporal, dynamic temporal. Don't pay attention to these crazy words. None. She can only shift between other realities without the control of time or space, dependent upon the reality's rules. Like here from it's basically a Scooby-Doo mystery that's naked.
Yes, a nudist colony Scooby-Doo story.
Yeah, from Loxie and Zoot. Now, here she's shifting in and she's falling down, she's parachuting in. She shifted somewhere and ended up likely still in the sky somewhere else, though.
Yep.
So, and then there's static spatial, where it's site-to-site shifting. I think she's site-to-site shifting in this. There's other examples, but this is the most visual example. I think she's just shifting around, kind of showing off.
The movie, the Peculiars that they are attempting to do, I believe she's a site-to-site teleporter in that one as well. Yeah, I think they've just got a couple of trailers for it. I don't know if they've ever
gotten all the
way.
They're all, like, experimental trailers.
Yeah.
He was actually, his backer kind of left him hanging dry and ended up losing his house.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
That sucks.
And then there's dynamic spatial, cross-site shifting. This isn't the best example of it, but it's still funny. Jenny can shift into any position in another reality. So some control of where she's going to be when she shifts, or no control depending on the rules of like, shifting from Australia. Again, from Legend of Jenny Everywhere. Static temporal time traveling, basically.
Yes, basically.
When I say static, that meant like in the same universe versus dynamic is between the other universes. So here's an example from Insert Comic here where she just gets bored and say, hey, let's go. And there they are in medieval times.
I do really love that version of Jenny.
And then there's dynamic temporal where she can shift to any time in another reality, though it's kind of hard to say because the other reality may be naturally at a different time, but like similar.
Yes.
If you ever seen like The One,
yeah,
which I liked.
Oh, no,
there is,
I loved it.
There's like one universe that's like 20 years behind the other universe.
Yeah.
It's pretty much the same thing. So you never can really tell.
The line I like to have in my head as I'm working on it is time is just another place. And I think that when it comes to that sort of stuff, like time is just another place. It's just another reality, just it's somewhere else in time.
Well,
you know,
I thought it was more like a big ball of
timey-wimey,
wobbly,
yes, exactly.
Timey-wimey stuff. This is from He Is Just a Rat, and you can see she shifts out into a city.